Thanks, Lauren. We see that aggression is a part of our lives. However, on the bright side, we also see that as humans, we engage in pro-social behavior. We would like to start this part of the lesson by going back to the first lesson on what is psychology. Do you remember when we talked about Kitty Genovese? Recall that Kitty Genovese was walking home to her apartment after work late one night, and a man attacked her outside of her apartment building. She screamed, and people turned their lights on. Then the attacker ran away. However, nobody called the police. Next, the attacker returned, and people heard more screams, and still nobody called the police. And then, in the end, he ended up killing Kitty. How is it that such a long, drawn-out murder can happen, and so many people can hear the attack, and yet no one, well, one person out of 38, even so much as calls the police? To answer this question, two researchers, Darley and Latney, designed an experiment to study what they came to call the bystander effect. Let's take a closer look at how this study was designed. The researchers had participants who were talking to each other via headsets. It turns out that the recordings were actually pre-recorded, and the participant was interacting with those pre-recorded conversations. In addition, the group sizes varied. Some thought that they were alone with one other person. Others thought they were in larger groups. Next, sometime during the conversation, the participant heard someone choking. Now remember, this was pre-recorded, but the participant did not know that. Now, before we move forward with the results, what would you do in that type of situation? You don't have to type an answer, but think about it for a moment.